The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you govern all things both in heaven and earth. Mercifully hear the supplications of your people, and in your time grant us your peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading is from Deuteronomy. Hear what the Lord says. Rise, plead your case before the mountains, and let the hills hear our voice. Hear, you mountains, the controversy of the Lord, and you enduring foundations of the earth. For the Lord has a controversy with his people, and he will contend with Israel. O my people, what have I done to you? In what have I wearied you? Answer me, for I brought you up from the land of Egypt and redeemed you from the house of slavery. And I sent before you Moses, Aaron, and Miriam. O my people, remember now what King Balak of Moab devised and what Balaam, son of Beor, answered him. And what happened from Sittim to Gilgal, that you may know the saving acts of the Lord. With what shall I come before the Lord and bow myself before God on high? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams and tens of thousands of rivers of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my transgression, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? He has told you, O mortal, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you, but to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please pray with me that portion of the 15th Psalm on the screen. Lord, who may dwell in your tabernacle? Who may abide upon your holy hill? Whoever leads a blameless life and does what is right, who speaks the truth from his heart. There is no guile upon his tongue. He does no evil to his friend. He does not heap contempt upon his neighbor. In his sight, the wicked is rejected, but he honors those who fear the Lord. He has sworn to do no wrong and does not take back his word. He does not give his money in hope of gain, nor does he take a bribe against the innocent. Whoever does these things shall never be overthrown.
Second reading is from Corinthians. The message about the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. For it is written, I will destroy the wisdom of the wise, and the discernment of the discerning I will thwart. Where is the one who is wise? Where is the scribe? Where is the debater of this age? Has not God made foolish the wisdom of the world? For since in the wisdom of God, the world did not know God through wisdom, God decided through the foolishness of our proclamation to save those who believe. For Jews demanded signs and Greeks desired wisdom, but we proclaim Christ crucified, a stumbling block to Jews and foolishness to Gentiles, but to those who are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ, the power of God and the wisdom of God. For God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. Consider your own call, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards, Not many were powerful, not many were of noble birth. But God chose what is foolish in the world to shame the wise. God chose what is weak in the world to shame the strong. God chose what is low and despised in the world, things that are not, to reduce to nothing things that are, so that no one might boast in the presence of God. He is the source of your life in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, and righteousness and sanctification and redemption, in order that, as it is written, let the one who boasts, boast in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
This report today, I want to give you a couple of things about it. The first thing is that it will be printed in the February newsletter. So if you want to doze off and take a bit of a nap, it's okay. Just ask someone next to you to wake you up when it's over. The second is that there's not a lot of numbers in it. We don't calculate attendance numbers for the past year and for another few weeks until we submit them to the National Church. And the financial numbers you will get in the meeting. And those will also be available after the meeting. So you're not going to get those today, so that helps to narrow it down to only about 3.5 hours. It is an honor to gather and reflect on our past year together and share some of our hopes for 2017. But I have to tell you, the real honor is for me to be your rector. I enjoy it, I love our time together, and I appreciate all that you bring. And it surprises me that this is my third annual report. I like to place my reports within a context. This year I want to proclaim who we are as a parish. It is a very simple proclamation. We live the good news of God in Christ. We live the gospel. Now, this should be the mission of every congregation, and probably at some level it is. But what do I mean? I mean we take the heart of the gospel, that God loves the world enough to become one of us, and live it. We live it within our walls in worship, education, fellowship, and administration. And we live it in the world, our community, Fort Myers, Florida, Honduras, and the world. It is the reason that we exist and is the basis for our ministry. It is about love, about God's love for the world. We were about many things in 2016. It was a year when we turned a major corner and moved out in some new ways. One of the things that your vestry and I talked about prior to and after my arrival was enhancing our fiscal responsibility. We talked about this in major endeavors such as retiring mortgage debt, and we talked about it in our year-to-year financial dealing. We decided that it would help us to plan if we moved our pledge campaign to the fall rather than after the first of the year. So 2016 was the year to do this. The stewardship committee under the excellent leadership of Patrick Hunt, Mike Donlan, and Bob Earle worked with the finance team, vestry, and you. The result was twofold. First, you came through in great ways, giving us enough to allow the vestry to pass a balanced budget for 2017. Second, the timely focus helped us to communicate our 2016 year-end needs to you in a clear way. If you remember, last year we passed a deficit budget. And as we approached the end of the year, it looked like we were going to come in at least $20,000 short. But you responded. We closed without a deficit. We balanced. We turned a corner. And you are to be thanked. And we were able to do this because you stepped up. And people like Jane Shafroth, who manages the thrift store, Donna Kress, who leads our after-school program, and the Reverend Susie Post gave valuable time to the work and ministries of Iona-Hope. And our staff and volunteers managed our finances judiciously. Now, this may seem distant from living the gospel, but we need all of our resources, time, talent, spiritual, and financial, to live the gospel. We cannot live it with a part of ourselves. Love involves every part of us. Additionally, we contracted with the Episcopal Church Foundation to explore executing a capital campaign. We are beginning this campaign, and you will hear more about it over the next few weeks from Robin Mills and Paula Paquette. It's exciting times. Now I want to take a look at some major shifts and changes in the past year. In 2015, I set as a goal that we increase opportunities for connecting with the community. We have well-established connections in the good work of Life Justice Ministry, whose work on civil citations for youthful offenders is having an impact at the state level. And our work in two food pantries and with other social ministries are well established. In 2016, we began a new and very important ministry. Changes that took place in our community in early 2016 negatively impacted the availability of after-school care for children in Harlem Heights. Many of them are in single-parent families where the parent usually the mother, works long and hard hours for minimal pay. Your vestry decided to address this, and in August we opened our after-school program. Currently, we have 9 children who attend our program, a program that is volunteer-led and donation-driven. We chose an organizational model that would allow parents to pay only $10 per week per child so that this could be affordable to them. Volunteers contribute time, food, and finances to the program. We are not trying to generate income, but to minister within the community. Donna Kress does a fine job leading this ministry. This has had a significant impact on these families, but it has also had a significant impact on Iona-Hope. You saw the children sing at our paper bag service on Christmas Eve. Even more importantly, if not most importantly, the topics of conversation at Iona-Hope have shifted to include children. As our buildings are filled with the voices of children, I hope that we will become more aware of their physical, emotional, and spiritual needs, and how we may represent God's love to them within our walls and in the community. And as a side note, we had our first Flakes of Hope tree this year. You gave 98 gifts. What a wonderful thing. In 2015, Iona-Hope was invited to join 2 ecumenical groups for worship. One group met at Thanksgiving while the other met on holy days during the year. Both of these groups feed us as we participate with them. Our participants from Iona-Hope are growing, and we are the most present for these when we host them. Nevertheless, we worshiped together as we became aware of the ministries of each congregation. As we met together, I wondered if there was not more for us to do together in the community. Having met Rabbi Mark Sack from Temple Judea, I hoped that Iona-Hope could become part of building interfaith relationships. Rabbi Mark participated with us in our Wednesday Wisdom and invited us to various happenings at the synagogue. After the Orlando shootings in 2016, I was contacted by Imam Muhammad Al-Dosani about being part of an interfaith group in response to the shootings. I, along with others, including Joe Molino, your senior warden, attended the initial meeting. I have met with them on a regular basis since then. Later, the opportunity arose for us to join an interfaith Thanksgiving service at Temple Judea. I am very pleased that a good group from Iona-Hope attended the service as well. Further, I am happy to announce to you that, one, as a group, we are looking at ways of deepening our interfaith relationships, including how we can together minister within the community. And second, our interfaith relationships will be the topic for our Wednesday Wisdom program in Lent. We will have presenters from various faith groups to engage us regarding their beliefs and practices. Now, we could not have offered these ministries without your presence, prayers, and financial support. It is important, too, to acknowledge the wonderful work of our musicians, Lauren, Christine, Tim, Janie, and Karen, as well as the choir. As well as programmers and booth workers for our services. Then too, there are Donna and Ken Owens, who take such wonderful care of our facilities, Cindy Farmer with her work in the office volunteers, the MCs, and various others who work throughout our parish. But let us not forget those who coordinate hospitality after our services. It's easy to take it as just happening, but it doesn't. And we are very grateful to Artis for all that she does. We're grateful, too, to the finance team and Vestry, who care very deeply for Iona-Hope and will always work with your best interest at heart. Last, I cannot end without acknowledging two others. The first is the Reverend Susie Post. Mother Susie is a very important part of Iona-Hope, serving in liturgy and pastoral care. Please hear this. She is a trusted colleague and dear friend. Second, I must acknowledge the very important contribution that Marnie Ike makes to Iona-Hope. We do. We do not pay her enough. In fact, we cannot pay her enough. She exceeds our expectations and is undying in her support of Iona-Hope. She loves you and will always do good work for you. We can trust her with anything, and I thank her, and I am sure that you will too. These three things, enhancing our financial situation, developing an after-school program for lower-income families, and developing and deepening our interfaith relationships, represent important work in 2016. You and I know that this is only part of what we've been about. We've developed the All God's Creatures Animal Ministry to care for those who we love. Had you been here at 3:45 yesterday afternoon, you would have seen a group of us praying for a dog that has been diagnosed with cancer. His caregivers are not part of Iona-Hope. Through your offerings, multiple support groups have a place to care for each other. Pastoral caregivers visit and take communion to folks unable to come to worship. We bless marriages and commend people we love to God's eternal care. We have laughed, cried, been angry, hurt, and joyous. And we have lived as part of God's blessed community. Thank you for all that you do and are in Iona-Hope. I look forward to 2017 and our good work together. The Mardi Gras event on February 24th will be a time of celebration as we raise funds for our common work. The capital campaign will help us discern future development and come together to forge a vision for the next few years. We will also need to deal with transportation issues related to our after-school program. There are so many ministries and endeavors that we will continue and grow while being open to new possibilities. Even so, it is love which will call us forth, energize, and sustain us. As our presiding bishop, Michael Curry, says, if it is about love, it is about God. So I close with our dismissal that we often use at the end of our service. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen. Amen.
Let us stand and profess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please pray with me. Our prayer for growth. Gracious God,
we ask that you increase our love of you and deepen our faith in you, so that we may be your faithful witnesses in this corner of your creation. Amen.
God the Creator, your will for all people is health and salvation.
We praise you and thank you, O God.
God the Redeemer, you come that we might have life and might have it more abundantly.
Guide us in your grace.
God the Sanctifier, you make our bodies the temple of your presence.
We praise you and thank you, O God.
Holy Trinity, one God, in you we live and move and have our being.
We praise you and thank you, O God.
O God, grant your healing grace to all who are sick, injured or disabled, that they may be made whole.
Hear us, O source of life.
Grant to all who seek your guidance, and to all who are lonely, anxious, or despondent, a knowledge of your will and an awareness of your presence.
Hear us, O source of life.
Mend broken relationships and restore those in emotional distress to soundness of mind and serenity of spirit.
Hear us, O source of life.
Bless physicians, nurses, and all others who minister to the suffering, granting them wisdom and skill, sympathy and patience.
Hear us, O source of life.
Grant to the dying peace and a holy death, and uphold by the grace and consolation of your Holy Spirit those who are bereaved.
Hear us, O source of life.
Restore to wholeness whatever is broken by human sin, in our lives, in our nation, and in the world.
Hear us, O source of life.
You are the one who does wonders.
You have declared your power among the peoples.
With you, O God, is the well of life.
And in your light we see light.
Hear us, O source of life.
Heal us and make us whole.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. For Michael, our presiding bishop, Dabney, our bishop, Ray, Susie, and for all of our retired clergy. And we pray also for St. Albans, St. Alfred's, St. Andrew's, St. Anne of Grace, St. Anselm's. We pray for Donald, our president, Rick, our governor, Randall, our mayor, and the Lee County commissioners. We pray for the ministries at Iona-Hope, especially the lay readers. We offer our thanksgivings for the many blessings of this day, for our guests and those celebrating birthdays and anniversaries. We pray for Christians, Muslims, and Jews, and all people of faith throughout the world who are suffering persecution for their beliefs. We pray for all who work for peace, especially those who give their lives that it may grow. We pray for all victims of terrorism and violence. We pray for the repose of the soul of Stephen and Jeremiah Nippard, relatives of Connie Walsh, who recently departed this life. We pray for those who are committed to our daily prayers, especially Mindy, David, Mary Ann, Andrew, Bill, Betty, Tom, Bruce, Dake, Ellie, Miriam, Tom, Bill, Carol, Bob, Rhonda, Bob, Gladys, Janelle, David, Patrick, Rebecca, and David Gamble. In our congregation, we pray for the Trainer family, the Treadway family, the Tretanero family, the Trotter family, the Tully family, and the Turk family. We also pray for our pets, especially Riley, Ginger Lee, Turbo, Cat Cat, and Jane. Are there others for whom we should pray, and blessings for which we give thanks?
Peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Yeah.
by the lakeside by blessing the gifts of a few people. Bless these gifts for the feeding of the needy, and bless us in your service, for we ask it in your name.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
All thanks and praise are yours at all times and in all places. Our true and loving God, through Jesus Christ, your eternal word, the wisdom from on high by whom you created all things. You laid the foundations of the world and enclosed the sea when it burst out from the womb. You brought forth all creatures of the earth and gave breath to humankind. Wondrous are you, Holy One of blessing. All you create is a sign of hope for our journey. And so as the evening stars sing your praises, we join the heavenly beings and all creation as we shout with joy.
Holy, 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 my heart.
People to yourself as a light to the nations. You delivered them from bondage and led them to a land of promise. Of your grace you gave Jesus to be human, to share our life, to proclaim the coming of your holy reign, and give himself for us, a fragrant offering. Through Jesus Christ our Redeemer, you have freed us from sin, brought us into your life, reconciled us to you, and restored us to the glory you intend for us. We thank you that on the night before he died for us, Jesus took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine, said the blessing, gave it to his friends, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And so, remembering all that was done for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, and ascension, longing for Christ coming in glory, in presenting to you these gifts your earth has formed and human hands have made, we acclaim you, O Christ.
Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Christ Jesus, come in glory.
Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and wine, that they may be to us the body and blood of your Christ. Grant that we, burning with your Spirit's power, may be a people of hope, justice, and love. Giver of life, draw us together in the body of Christ, and in the fullness of time, gather us with Columba and all your people into the joy of our true eternal hope. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, we worship you, our God and Creator, in voices of unending praise.
Blessed are you now and forever. Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our
Father in heaven,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
This is the true bread which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world.
Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
So come to this table, you who have much faith, and you who would like to have more. You who have been here often, and you who have not been here for a long time. You who have tried to follow Jesus, and you who have failed. Come. It is Christ who invites us to meet him here.
Trust in me and you will love us. Eat this bread.
thanksgiving for all the gifts we have received, let us pray together, saying,
Loving God, we give you thanks for restoring us in your image and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood. Now send us forth a people forgiven, healed, renewed, that we may proclaim your love to the world and continue in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen.
May Christ, the Son of God, be manifest in you, that your lives may be a light to the world. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.